More often than not, financial institutions have continued to encourage more people to adopt the savings culture as a way of not only growing their assets, but also plan for uncertainties that could arise. However, what does not come out clearly is that saving is not just about keeping money on the side, but rather planning on what one intends to use it for and after what period.
And again, that was an opportunity for us to again reach out to more potential savers as part of our strategy. The other thing that I realized, it was very important for us to have a target. Yes, you can have a strategy, but you must set a figure and say, but you know, we need to work towards this target. And incidentally, I am a man of great faith. I have not been able to count what's in the envelope, but I'm almost certain that we have hit that target.
Speaking during the handover of the savings piggy bank to Insurance Regulatory Authority by the Uganda Insurers Association, Bank of Uganda was commended for this initiative. Statistics show that Uganda is amongst countries with the lowest savings to GDP ratio at just 9%, while China is at 44.9%, Nigeria 33.9%, South Africa 16%, Kenya 16%, and Rwanda 15%.
I may not say it is because of our incomes being low. Probably there is something that we need to do, and things like these, which have to do with actual action, probably will help us improve this ratio in the near future. Because after all, like my sister from BOU mentioned, investment is a function of savings, by and large. So if we don't save, investment becomes hard, employment generation becomes hard, the economy will be stagnant, etc. So this looks like a small thing, but to me, I think it creates a foundation for bigger things that can cause transformation.
According to the Bank of Uganda annual report for the period ended June 2021, the number of Ugandans who saved declined from 18.1% in 2019 to 16.3%.